First of all, you're looking at that going, oh, I remember filming that. That was so awful.
Yeah, it was amazing. We do sometimes a bit out of order, but we did all the rain and the storm in, like, three night shoots where we filmed like till the morning time.
So it's like it's a baptism of fire to get back into it, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, when you're straight back in, fantastic that she's come back and with this.
In a storm.
Quite right.
With some evil intent as well. I mean, she's a great character, isn't she?
Yeah, she's brilliant. I love playing her. There's so many dynamics to it. And
so, what's the reason within the plot for her coming, bringing her back to the village then?
Well, she's coming back for Steve and Harry's wedding. To have a revenge. So that's what she wants to do. But obviously then she gets caught up in this whole storm and she meets Sammy on the way, which was nice working with him as well because it's like a new character I've not worked with before. So, yeah, it was brilliant. It was really good.
So you're back and loving it. I bet everyone was delighted to see you back as well.
They were. It was weird because it was like I've never left. It's like I've always been there. It's like I stepped out and then went back in. I was like, oh... Like, everyone's treated me like I've never been away because I grew up there, didn't I?
You did.
It was pretty dark times for you, wasn't it, when you left? Can you remember where your head was back then and what was going on for you?
Yeah, I think at the time, you know, I was young and I went through, like, I grew up in TV and I felt like maybe in my head at the time I thought I was missing being a young teenager, so I was wanting to party. But now I know, obviously... because I'm an alcoholic, I just wanted to go out and drink, but I didn't understand. I knew something was wrong with me, but I couldn't pinpoint when I was that young what it was, because typically, like, the stigma, I thought, well, I can't be an alcoholic. Like, that's a homeless guy in the street with a paper bag, the typical, you know, what everyone thinks. And then it was only years later, when someone said this, this and this, I was like, that's me.
So was there a moment then that you suddenly realised that it wasn't just that you were enjoying having a drink with your friends, but actually it was a motivating factor to everyday life?
Yeah, it was towards the end, like, a year and the year before. And obviously I went through a really bad time and that was my coping mechanism to get through things. And at the beginning, it was the solution and I thought it was helping me, but then it starts to take and take. Mm. And in the end, you know, I was going to die. It was really sad. And
what do you mean you were going to die? How did that?
Well, I did try to kill myself, and then the way I was drinking, because it got quite bad, I was either going to hit my head or I was going to. My body couldn't take anymore, so it just got to the point where I give up the fight, and I was like, I want to be me again, because I wasn't me. I was an empty, lost soul. Sad.
How did you then think, having hit that moment in your head? What did you then do?
I was sat on my stairs with my mum and my auntie one day and I just gave up. Something switched in my head and I was like, I need to go to rehab, I need help. Like, and they cried and I was looking at them thinking, why are they crying? Tears of happiness. I was like, what? And they were made up because they said, we're going to get the old Stephanie back. And then I went on my journey and it was really, really hard. Don't get me wrong, I've had to do a lot of work on myself, but I'm so thankful for it now.
You've also said that... Paul Gascoigne's been a sort of a real sort of help to you along the way as well. We know that Paul is a friend of mine and is still struggling and battling every day as he does. But how did he help you?
I think there's nothing better than one addict helping another addict. You have that understanding that no one else does. And, you know, we're both in the public eye and, you know, to me, he's Paul, not Gazza. You know what I mean?
And how did you meet him?
I met him, like, last year through similar circumstances. And we just kind of, it's like we just got each other and I helped him and he helped me. And yeah, it's a day at a time for him, you know what I mean? So he's sober today, that's amazing.
So how confident do you feel that you're on the way up now and continuing up? You're back in Hollywood, everything's good. Because there's always that, as you say, day at a time.
It's a day at a time, yeah. But I think for me, it was more my self-worth. I didn't love myself. And I had to fix what was in the inside.
Which is strange because people look at you so successful from a young age.
Yeah, and I didn't see it. I was so lonely and so suicidal. And people couldn't... My mum was like, look at... Yeah, she wanted to shake me, but I didn't see it. You know, I was so depressed. And then since I went through that journey, like, it was the hardest thing I've ever had to do, don't get me wrong. But now, how my life's changed and I'm getting to help other people, that's the most amazing thing. Because I thought I could stay quiet about this. Or I could be vocal about it and help other people, which I've done. So it makes it all worth it.
And, of course, your mum as well, little Caban. And that must be sort of, you know, the greatest job in the world.
Yeah, he's amazing. He saved me. He really did. He's the light of my life. He's just... the most beautiful little soul. I can't even tell you. He's really advanced for his age. He's just amazing. I still can't believe he's mine.
Well, look, amazing. Good luck. Come Friday. We'll all be,
watching. Yeah, yeah.
Tune in Friday.
Exactly
yeah. It's going to be amazing.
Yeah. But it's lovely that you're looking so well, Stephanie.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
Cheers.